It was a very, very complex situation. Fortunately, we could envisage that something bad is coming by the time of Holi. Because at that time, we were going through the newspapers and everything. So even before the lockdown, I don't remember, it was in middle of March, I think the lockdown was announced, but our Holi was in the first week of March or something like that. Immediately after that, we gave the notice to the students so that they do not come back to the institute till further notice. That enabled us to keep the hostels free. And the students were, the campus was shut down during lockdown. Also the faculty were operating from their home. The employees were also asked to stay back at their home. Therefore, I can, although the second wave is coming, I am keeping my fingers crossed. But fortunately for the first wave, NIT Durgapur faculty, staff didn't have many incidences, maybe except for one or something. And that too was not from within the campus, but from outside the campus. Somebody who stayed outside the campus. And one was, yes, one was from within the campus. But it was quite contained. On the other hand, obviously the entire academic life stream was jeopardized. I mean, without, I just cannot imagine an institute or university running without students. But that also enabled us to test the test of online education, all right? And much touted online education. Somebody joined NIT but have never seen the institute. And the final years, it's really painful because we always carry a lot of sweet memories, a lot of emotions when we leave the institute where we had spent four or five years. I mean, I can remember my student days and I really feel very sad for the final year students because they will be graduating and they will be joining the jobs. But to compensate it to some extent, what we are trying, and we are really trying hard, that after the elections are over, West Bengal elections are over, unless the second wave of COVID sweeps us out, I hope it will not, we will bring the students and have them, because we can't give them degrees without doing the labs. You know, and all the labs cannot be done online. And so, we'll bring them, maybe for a short burst of time, where they can meet their classmates. It may be that they will meet their departmental mates and others, maybe may not be all. And I hope that will be possible so that they can get that feeling of meet and feeling of being there. So this alphabet E actually is the most frequent alphabet in the English texts, you know. If you take a statistics, you will find that the alphabet E appears most frequently. Now here in this situation, we find that the E is playing a different role. Everything is becoming E, E class. Another meaning of E, that's entrepreneurship, right? Entrepreneurship summit. One E is becoming a necessity. Another E, the entrepreneurship, is a very encouraging step. Because the young minds, I could see at the universities abroad, students really take to it. And I have seen that even earlier, people used to start startup companies, and often the startups did not succeed. But that the failure of startups were also taken as a positive qualification by big companies. Anybody who tried a startup and struggled and failed were absorbed by big companies because they have really burnt their fingers and they have learnt. So entrepreneurship, startups is obviously a very good step, and I'd say that it is a learning process. It's a component of the learning process.